don't pretend podcasting isn't boring.
Today, a doctor that specializes in circumcision in Turkey tells us a little bit about his job and his life. Enjoy it. Okay, so first I would like to ask, how are you today? Are you fine?
Thank you, Juan Carlos. Welcome to Ankara.
Yes, thank you very much.
Again.
Yeah. So you are fine, you're good.
Yeah.
With your dogs.
On weekends I try to rest because I work hard on weekdays.
Yes.
Now I'm resting today. Tomorrow also I will rest and I will work hard again on Monday.
Yeah. So for people that don't know, Ergan is a doctor and he's a surgeon. And you specialize on
a very different part of medicine. I'm making male circumcision, Muslim circumcision, children's circumcision, yeah.
But it's very profitable, right? It's good. It's a good business.
Yeah. It's a religious habit.
Yeah.
You don't have to do it. It's not a must in Islam also, but it is a must in Jewish religion. In Islam it is not must, but all of people 100% is circumcised in Turkey. All people make circumcision.
And the people that you receive are mostly Muslims or from?
Totally Muslims.
Yeah.
But in some areas, I have one friend, for example, in Antalya.
Yeah.
Russian women bring their boys to circumcise. They are Christian also, but also in US, it's a big habit. 50%, nearly 50%, 40% of Christians prefer circumcision,
yeah.
But also they are Christian.
Now, circumcision also supposed to be like cleaner. Is it true? Is that true?
Yeah.
What is?
Yeah. Circumcision is, first of all, in my opinion, not for men. It is it's good for women.
Okay.
Yeah, because penis becomes really clean. There is a bad smell. Maybe some people can't find it bad, but it's a humidity, metabolism, secretion, and there is a smell in penis. So not non-circumcised penis smells, I think. But if you circumcise it, it is open and becomes clean and don't smell bad. So it is better than.
Okay, that is the first time I hear something like that. But it may be true.
It's true. But there are really some certain rules. It may be made carefully and only expert doctors have to make it, because the others can destroy penis. It may be harmful, really harmful, but if it is made with a certain rules and with an expert doctor, it may be. So there is no danger. It's not dangerous and it's not harmful in my opinion.
And how do you decide to go for that? Like, one day you say like, yeah, this is the business, or?
Yeah, I'm a doctor. I'm still examining patients as a family doctor.
Yeah.
I have a private day hospital. I'm the owner of that day hospital. I love children. It's a hard day for children to be circumcised. So I'm trying to make easier that moment for children, and I'm trying to not be harmful for psychiatric for them. I earn money also. it's a good part of medical preferences.
Yeah.
So I choose circumcision.
It's a win-win situation.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
make the kids feel yeah. better in a hard time.
Yeah,
and
families feel good. So in medical, it is a religion habit. It's a religion circumcision. So in they don't teach us in medical faculty. Also, they don't teach in other ways. If you wonder it and try to learn it, you learn it classically from the other doctors who learned it.
Yeah.
So I learned it from my old elder friends.
Yeah.
Now I'm making 600, 700 circumcisions in a year.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a lot of stuff that you see every day. But you are not also a doctor. You are kind of like a star in Twitter, right?
No, not a star. I'm writing stories. I'm writing real life stories about we can call it as a doctor's diary.
Yeah.
I'm writing small stories and people like to read it. Also, medical faculty, medicine faculty students follow me and they read. I'm writing sometimes about emergency experience. I'm writing sometimes about as a soldier, as an army doctor.
Yeah.
Sometimes a sport doctor.
Yeah.
Many stories about all kind of medicine.
Yeah.
People like it. I'm writing, and I enjoy it. I like reading. Reading feeds you. If you read a lot, you can. It's really hard to writing because if you think a lot, you can. It's easy to explain something to people by speaking, but it's really hard to explain by writing because yeah. you have to show your ideas by writing. So. I'm experting myself. I'm improving myself
yeah.
while writing.
What is one of crazy stories that you have written, like on the top of your head?
Yeah, the best one, the most.
The funniest?
Yeah, reading was a man who take a wrong drug about. Diabetes.
Okay.
So yeah, he becomes nearly shock. He becomes hypotension and loses his mind because his glucose, blood sugar really decreases. When it decreases, it makes coma, nearly coma, pre-coma.
Wow.
So your psychiatry all changes. You become a psychiatry disease.
Wow.
Yeah. It was very funny to find the real
reason.
Yeah, and at the end, people doesn't believe. They think he is rolling. At the end, I found the reason, and then treated the patient.
Yeah.
And he become normal. it was a really funny story.
So you're like a Dr. House.
You yeah,
know Dr.
Yeah,
House.
Yeah,
you're
of course.
The kind of like Dr. House.
Yeah.
And what kind of behavior he was displaying? Like.
Yeah, he forgets everything. He doesn't recognize his friends, his family. So he tries to beat somebody easily.
Wow.
So people can't believe how he become like this. When we calculated his blood sugar, his glucose, it was 30-35 milligram deciliters. It's very low. It have to be more than 60.
Yeah.
Then we gave him dextrose serum.
Yeah.
It increases blood glucose and After he became normal, he tried to understand where he is, what happened to him.
And that's how you became the famous doctor, right?
No.
Everybody was like, wow, he solved it.
Yeah.
That's yeah. very nice.
It was in the beginning my medical practice. It was maybe 20 years ago.
Okay.
I have many memories like this, and if I have time, I'm trying to write these.
Yes. Yeah. That's very nice. That's very nice. And you also are a father, right?
Yes.
How is to raise kids in Turkey? Is it difficult? Is it nice? Is it like any other place?
We are a democratic family. We try to be friends with children. That's a freedom way. Our choice is liberal way. So it is not hard to grow up children for us. We can talk everything with my children.
Yeah.
I'm their friend also. We don't have certain rules. We always speak, try to convince them, and then try to learn their opinions about rules.
Yeah.
So I don't think it is it's hard to grow up children. Before pandemic, we decided to make the fourth children with my wife because we really love children and enjoy. But after pandemic, clinics closed, so yeah. Yeah. We are waiting.
And well, both of your daughter and one of your son is like dancer, dancer.
Yeah, they are dancing. It's very hard. They are also attending competitions in Turkey. There are 10 type of dance, 5 modern dances, they say, originally European dances. The other 5 is Latin dances.
Yeah.
They have partners also and have degrees in Turkish competitions.
Yeah.
My son once went to a European competition in Athens in Greece, had also degree there.
Yeah.
They are working hard, but it is really hard.
What your son may not know is that dancing will bring a lot of girls.
Yeah, he knows.
He knows.
He knows also, more than us.
And also he plays the guitar, right?
Yeah, he plays electric guitar now. Before he was playing acoustic guitar, classical guitar. He loves music, also dancing. After dancing, he had abilities. He began to wonder about rhythms, about music also. Then he listens to music. He tries to solve the rhythm and tries to imagine how can he dance with that music. So it's dancing makes people more interested with music also.
What do you think about like parenting? I see that you put a lot of effort in give your children like the tools for succeed.
Yeah.
I would say, how important do you think is that for like normal parenting?
Education or interesting children?
Like the extracurricular activities that you encourage your kids to have.
Yeah. Education is very important. For example, if you give a good education, to new generation, for example, I believe that Turkey can be the richest country in the world. But if you can't make this, you will be the worst.
Yeah.
So it's very important. For example, I think about money sometimes. I think about money for Turkish lira, or I can say US dollar. $200, $300 will be enough to live for me. I only need money, I think, that are for children's education. In Turkey, it is, unfortunately, you can't get a good education in government schools. You have to send your children good private schools. I think that I only need much money for children's private education. So I spent money for them, but only for university degree. After I will stop.
Yeah.
And they will build their own life.
Yeah. Now we are in a country that was able to manage coronavirus quite efficiently, but particularly what I've seen in the statistics is the amount of deaths have been like they stop around 5,000 and they increase maybe little. What do you think, as a doctor, what do you think is the things that they did right?
Yeah, it's about health system. Turkey has a good health system, really. We are successful, cheap and luxury. Let me explain with an example to you. In maybe in November or January this year, I have many relatives in Italy. There is a lake, Como, named very luxury lake in the north point of Italy.
Uh-huh.
My relatives have hotels there, restaurants in the lakeside. One of my relatives had an accident, dropped from the third floor, fourth floor, and injured really badly. And they went to Italian hospital. He stayed there nearly 1 year. They were calling me every month, please take him to Turkey, please take him to Turkey. They are not giving a treatment here. Everything is very bad, they said, about Italian health system. So in January, airplanes doesn't accept him because he have to fly with lying. So we found, at the end we found the ambulance, land ambulance, and they bring him from Italy to Ankara.
Wow.
Yeah, they two drivers, they drive for 24 hours, 25 hours non-stop and came to Turkey. And he really began to walk after that, after treatment in Turkey.
Yes.
So I'm now comparing Turkey and Italy. You ask about Corona, the worst country about Corona was Italy.
Yeah.
Because I know that they have really have a bad health system.
Yeah.
And they also, my relatives told me that there were patients with my relative in the same hospital, mostly died in this pandemic because they sent most of them to houses. They don't have beds. So it's your answer of your question is that Turkey really have a good health system. So we obeyed the basic rules about Corona. So I think the death number in Turkey is less about.
Do you think the use of remdesivir on time was one of the factors?
No.
No.
Remdesivir is not a treatment drug. Corona has a different effect. When corona gets in your lungs, in your cells, lung cells, our metabolism, our body tries to kill corona.
Yes.
Our immune system tries to kill corona, but while this battle, while this war, our own cells dies too.
Okay.
Remdesivir prevents our body to kill our own cells. They don't kill coronavirus.
Oh.
Yeah, okay.
why they use it here?
So it's about that. To prevent our body to kill our own cells, not to kill corona. So we need it.
Oh.
Because when corona gets on our lung cells,
yeah,
our body begins to destroy our own cells. So to prevent it, you have to use some medicines like that.
Okay, I understand. I understand. Now, I'm also very fascinated of you as a kind of analyst of the politician landscape in Turkey. How is the landscape nowadays? What do you think?
Again.
What is the landscape in Turkey about this?
Yeah, I'm hopeful, as I told you before. Turkey is very near to Europe. We have a not democracy, but we have a republic more than 100 years. So we see all benefits of European democracy, the life, luxury, the style of humans in Europe. So educated Turkish people also wants the same. I am also an educated people, and I see Italy, Greece, Germany, and I say that I want the same. I want the same democracy. I want the same luxury. So there is only one way to have this degree on democracy. So we need democracy. At the end, Turkey will have the democracy, real democracy, because we are trying it not for 100 years, more than 150 years.
Yeah.
Turkish people trying to get a real democracy also in Ottoman Empire time.
Erdogan, is it going to win or lose?
In my opinion, he lose. Not we lose, he lose. We are now waiting for on elections. He lost in Istanbul, he lost in Ankara, Adana, Izmir, all Bursa, not Bursa, but all big cities in Turkey. He lost in the elections, but there are still more than 2 years for elections, and we are all waiting a new election.
Yeah.
He will lose, I'm sure.
Yeah. What do you think about the recent discovery about this natural gas? And
we don't know about it. Before every elections, they announce we found petroleum, we found gas, we found gold. So it may be true. I can't. I don't know. It may be really true, and I will be happy also. But I can't believe easily because of the past, because in the past they lied many times.
Yeah.
So it may be true, it will be good then, but still we will need democracy, because Saudi Arabia have the have a big reserves. Also Russia has natural gas, petroleum, but they don't have democracy, and people living there wants to immigrate to Europe, wants to leave, wants to go to Europe. As we told yesterday, Syrian people doesn't want to go to Saudi Arabia, doesn't want to go to rich Arabic countries. They all want to go to Germany.
Yes.
For democracy,
yes.
For have human rights.
It's because of the rights that they want to go, or they think that they are going to have better quality of life.
Yeah, they can have better quality of life in an Arabic rich country, but
yes.
Nobody goes there.
Yeah.
They can be rich also in Qatar. They can be rich also United Arab Emirates.
Okay, so it's about the democracy, you think?
Yeah, and also rights. Nobody. There are no certain rules. There is democracy. Nobody judge you. Nobody. All people respects you. Respects your habits. Respect your religion. Respect your style of life. This is important, I think.
Yeah.
In well-developed countries, the most important thing is respect. I think everybody respect each other.
Yeah. In a sense, this provide more freedom, I would say.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. I agree.
And finally, what do you think about the Muslim life here. We were talking a little bit about it while we were coming here. What do you think? Is it good? Is it bad? What are the positive sides?
There are two types of Muslim style, Muslim lifestyle.
Yes.
One is fundamentalism or political Islam, we can say. They are trying to make all people Muslim. They are trying to convince all people and build a life, Islamic life in the country. And there is another group. They don't put the religion the center of their life. They believe in God, they believe in Muhammad, they Prophet Muhammad, and they believe Islam, but not pray five times a day, maybe go on only on Fridays. Majority is like this in Turkey, and also the first group, the Islamic group, tries to build a life, Islam, build the Islamic life with roots before 1,005 years ago.
Yes.
Yeah. For example, it is written in Quran that you can beat a woman, not every time. In some rare cases, you can beat. It is written, but in this century, in this time, you can't beat a woman. You can't beat anybody. It's nonsense. So we have to say that. The Quran and the rules was for all for that time.
Yes.
The rules about social life was in the past.
Yes.
There are rules for this, different rules for now.
For now.
Yeah.
Okay. And basically, you think that those rules are more like about community and things like that, right? Like
yeah.
That we should preserve.
Yeah. You have to be religion. I understand from Islam to be honest. I understand Islam brotherhood. I understand Islam humanity, peace. I understand peace, not rules of 1,000 years ago.
Yes.
There are different rules. There are technology, time changed, life changed. So, but humanity doesn't change. Peace, brotherhood, they doesn't change. I have to be honest. I have to be a good person. I understand religion. I understand Islam. These topics.
Yeah, I understand. Okay, so thank you very much for
You're
talking
welcome.
With me. And yeah, I hope I'm staying with Erkan, by the way. This has been a very good host with me. And yeah. Let's continue the talking later. So this has been the end of the episode. I hope you like it. Remember that you can support my work in my Patreon account and buy me a coffee account as Juan Around. You can follow, share and subscribe in all my social media. Twitter, Facebook, etc. as Juan Around. And I hope you enjoy it. See you around.